Here we are back in Baltimore this morning, and there she is. The bridge that collapsed with the container ship still under her. Luckily for me, that's not my route out of here. Still a sad story. As you can see, there's still quite a few machines left in the port here. It's going to empty out pretty quickly. I talked to the staff inside. They're down to half staff already here right now. They don't know when it's going to open up for these ships to be able to get in and out. This ship is stuck in here. Morning, we're picking up a 336 Caterpillar. Came in again from China. And I'm just waiting on a checker right now. So our machine's in the second row. Back here. I gotta move this 340 to get to our 336. This is our machine in the back. This little 336 right here. I say little because I usually haul big mining equipment. I usually do 50 tons and up. But this is still a pretty decent size machine for a medium to large size construction company. Weighs 76,000 pounds. It's still a good machine. But luckily I noticed that the machine in front of it that I gotta move has a good scratch on the counterweight, and I don't want to be caught at the controls with the scratch in the machine. So I'm waiting for a checker to come by here, check that out, and approve that I can move that machine and that's not me who damaged it, so that I can get to mine.
Thank you. Thank you.
we just got finished loading up here in Baltimore. This 336 on the beam. Before anybody says anything, I didn't put pins in the sprockets to tighten the tracks up because they're not really hanging down very far. This is a brand new machine. The tracks are brand new and it's not really a big machine. It's up high enough off the ground. There's no track sag, so I didn't bother putting any track tighteners in. On a bigger machine or an older machine, if it was sagging down, I would have put some tighteners in the tracks. Got some dry clothes on. Days like today, coffee maker in the truck is priceless. Really nice to get some dry clothes on, get a warm coffee to warm up. This 336 is going up to Quebec. Again, we're still in spring weight restrictions, so it's going to be unloaded at the Quebec border and going to be put on a bigger trailer. Why did we use a beam trailer this week? Bossman told me that this was the only trailer available. No other reason than that. Usually we just put these on normal drop side trailers. Maybe the boss man thought I needed a workout. But I've loaded them before on these trailers. Takes a lot of the guessing out of it. I know exactly how much wood I need, exactly the size of the wood blocks that I need and everything. So it all went pretty good. We got it all first shot. Still have an escort that's meeting us outside the gate here in Maryland, but we're small enough on seven axles that we do not need the police escorts today in Maryland. So one less thing to arrange and schedule. Get used to this truck with the turning radius with the fourth pin on axle on the back. For those of you who are new to this channel, this truck takes a pin on axle. I got the choice of having a three axle truck or a four axle truck. It's not ideal, but it makes the truck a lot more versatile. I can haul different size loads, different configurations. But of course, the truck doesn't exactly drive the same with the pin on axle on or off. Don't really have a hard routing. This load's not really a big load. We're just under 12 feet wide. So I don't know how much we're gonna get on the way for filming, but maybe if the rain lightens up, I'll put the cameras out anyway. Still a lot of machinery left in the port here, but it's not necessarily stuff that's coming in. Could be stuff waiting to go out. Looks like Mr. Baltimore Express. Like I was saying, a lot of these machines, they actually came in to go overseas. They're export machines waiting to go out. Just as much stuff comes out of the Port of Baltimore as goes in. Stuff goes both ways. I asked them inside if they have a time frame for when the shipping lanes are going to be open, and they don't know. So
There's still quite a few machines in there. I don't know if how many of them we have, but I might be still back here a time or two before the port empties out. As you can see, it's still raining pretty good. We're up in Harrisburg right now. Gonna go into the truck stop, scale this, throw on some fuel. Should give me enough to get back up to Quebec and make some more coffee. Pennsylvania's pretty sticky about sticking to the routing, even just to stop for fuel. So we do get this truck stop on the permit. On my permit, I have the exit for the truck stop and even the overpass. So if we get stopped here by chance and the guy wants to be a smart ass, I can give him my permit and say I'm still on my permitted route. these fuel pumps are a little bit narrower. I'm not gonna try to fit through them. Just double check there's nobody parked behind us, and we're just gonna back up and go around. Our weights are good, pretty happy about that. We scaled before getting fuel, so I added about an extra 1,000 pounds to our overall weight. Always good to keep in mind. Right now we're leaving Harrisburg. We got about 3 hours to get up to Binghamton. Puts us there about 5:15. We have curfew in Binghamton from 4 to 6, so I'll probably go up and park at the New York Welcome Center. In the winter time, that would be it for today, would be stopping there, but the days are starting to get a little bit longer. We can actually drive after curfew. It's still daylight a little bit. So I'll wait, I'll leave the New York Welcome Center around 6 o'clock and cross Binghamton tonight and go park again. And that way we don't have to worry about curfew in the morning, because we would have curfew again in the morning from 7 to 9. The days are getting longer. We can do a little bit more in a day. So we're here at the New York Welcome Center, still on schedule. We got a little bit over 30 minutes to kill here until we can pass Binghamton after 6 o'clock curfew. Good time to check everything over, do a tire and load check, check all the chains, tighten anything up that we have to. Especially when you load stuff on wooden blocks, it's very possible that the blocks squish a little bit as you're going down the road. The chains can come loose. Always got to check everything over. Make sure none of the blocks are cracked or splitting. Make sure everything's tight. Make sure all the lights are working. Morning, guys. Well, surprise, we woke up back to winter this morning.
We got a couple inches of fresh snow overnight. We knew it was coming. The weatherman was calling for it. Winter's not over yet. The road crew has been doing a pretty good job. The highway's just wet. They got the salt on it, so it's melting off. We're gonna give it a try anyway.
Just cleared customs. Welcome back to Canada. We're not crazy big today, so we'll take the truck route. They got like a cattle chute around the back here for the trucks to go around. If you've watched some of my other videos, you see with really big loads, it's actually wider to go through the right-hand car lane than it is to take the truck lane here. But today we'll go this way. Again, this load is getting transferred here in Lacolle, Quebec, onto a bigger trailer.
beautiful weather we're having. So now that we got this all unchained, the next step is we got to get the wood out that's sandwiched underneath the machine. And how we're going to do that, I'm going to lift up the gooseneck, we're going to put these 6-inch blocks underneath and set it back down. See if that's high enough. And I go around to the other side. Now I'm going to deflate the air suspension in both the trailer and the truck. And now we're going to put the machine back down and detach the gooseneck. Put our support block in. Watching the eyes in the front of the trailer, making sure I get all the weight off of it. Undo our electrical and air. Pull the safety pin, and we'll advance the truck. Thank you. I'll give these blocks a try, but I believe they're still tight, which they are. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna start the machine and use the bucket to lift up the machine to get the blocks loose. First, we should probably take the exhaust cover off. Take my gloves off because I wouldn't want anyone running my machine with their dirty gloves on. Give this thing a minute to warm up. We are sitting on blocks, so at least with a bucket like that, if it falls, it won't fall far. See if I hit my camera there. And we'll give her a bit of power. And let's go see if that was enough to free up our blocks. Yes.
those ones are still kind of, we're gonna have to lift it a little bit higher. Let's try that. There we go. Now we can set it down on the 6-inch blocks, we'll be able to dry right off. Went on forwards, so we'll come off backwards. And we'll clear the trailer. Ah, de rien! Travail d'équipe! On se fait l'entraide, c'est un travail d'équipe! Là, t'as la bonne rigueur. Ouais, ben, c'est le dernier d'après moi, c'est le dernier là.
Ouais, ben ça me dérange pas là, mais vas-y comme tu disais, je sais pas pourquoi je fais ça, c'est à cause que j'aime ça pour le chien. C'est vrai ça aussi.
Hey! Bonne fête de semaine!
Merci, je vais aller payer, moi, je vais aller voir la petite madame en bas.
Ah!
Bonne fête de semaine! Ouais, il reste l'Ontario, il y a une main!
Guy was having trouble getting his trailer hooked up and unhooked, so I gave him a hand before I started with mine. Help each other out, because you never know what come back to you someday. Thank you.
And that's it, that's all, y'all. I just got to put the trailer back together, got to take that shim out, and then I'm going home for the weekend. Thanks for watching, y'all. If you're liking these videos, I'll keep them coming. Keep on trucking.